This video is sponsored by Clean My Mac X. If you need to speed up your Mac or PC, then Clean My Mac is for you. This program also combats malware and viruses and has a ton of other features that I use on a daily basis. So if you want to speed up your computer and protect it at the same time, check out Clean My Mac via the link in the video description below. What's up guys, it's Jeff, and today Apple released the second beta of iOS 12.1. So with iOS 12.1 beta 2, let's see if there are any new features, any performance boost, and maybe check out some bugs that needed to be fixed in beta 1. Okay, so first thing is first, you want to check out some new features, and there is the live aperture within the camera app specifically for the new generation iPhone XS devices. So you can now control the aperture before and after your pictures are taken, and obviously that is a really cool feature. Personally, I think that this works, but it doesn't work exactly perfectly, so I think Apple has a little work to do until this becomes a fully baked feature. Now in the settings app, you have the option to add a cellular plan under the cellular menu. Now this option is also limited to the XS models, as this is a way to attach those eSIM cards to your phone plan, and those are only installed onto XS devices. So if you have a cell provider that supports that feature, you can in fact get that going under this menu. Past that, no changes to any existing new features, but there has, however, been changes to the iPhone XS UI, specifically in the Settings app. So in the About menu, when you have a separate Bluetooth device like a Beats product, you would typically see the information only. But now with that information, you also get the button here, which points you to the right direction as far as finding an app to control the specific device it's showing. So having that information about a connected Bluetooth device is really cool already, but having this guide to more control over that specific device is also a really useful feature to have. Now, when you go into the portrait mode in the camera app, you will now be presented with this new screen here, and this only came up on the iPhone XS, not the 10, so I'm assuming this is specific to newer devices that have just updated to iOS 12.1. So there may be further improvement to the portrait mode, specifically in iOS 12.1. When you open the podcast app now, you get a similar cover screen, which gives you more information on the podcast app. And of course, at the bottom, you get some information on how Apple's managing your privacy. When you go into the podcast app, you will now see the Now Playing menu pop up, which just briefly shows you how you can manage your podcasts and how you can control them when they are playing. Now, past those very few changes, we also saw some more Memoji customization and improvements made to the facial mapping process. So for the iPhone X, nothing really seemed to have gotten better, but there is further improvement of the front-facing camera and Memoji on the iPhone XS. There doesn't seem to be as many stutters, and really all of the movements seem to be a lot more smooth, and it just makes for a much better recording in the long run. Now, there was an issue where the widget page wouldn't exactly snap back to where it was supposed to be. When we have the clock up, it seems to work just fine, but when we go to the page that doesn't have the integrated clock, it seems to snap back at the point where the clock would have filled that space. Super weird bug, and so far Apple hasn't fixed this issue, so hopefully they fix it in the very near future. It's very annoying for me, but I know a lot of you guys were asking me if that was changed, and so far, no changes to that bug. Now, another issue that we noticed was in the Contacts app, and the name would include some script below it, which obviously isn't meant to be there. This is, however, fixed in beta 2 and no issues so far in the Contacts app. Now, moving on to one of the biggest issues I've seen in iOS 12.1, and that is battery life. It's actually pretty awful with XS specific devices running iOS 12.1 beta 1. I'm actually thoroughly disappointed, to be honest. Just using the camera app for only 3 minutes wasted almost 10% of my battery life, which to me is just downright ridiculous. I wasn't in fact shooting video, I was only taking pictures, and that was it. So hopefully this is fixed within beta 2. More news on that as I use beta 2 for the next few days. So let's move on to performance. We went ahead and ran a Geekbench test and found that really there was no change in performance on the CPU side of things. Everything was in the margin of error, and that's really not worth talking about. But we did, however, see a big difference on the compute or GPU side of things over beta 1. We actually are scoring 2,000 points higher, sitting just above 22,200 points on beta 2, and this is likely due to further improvement of the A12 Bionic chip. You can't really see this change or improvement in graphics performance simply because everything was so smooth and fast before, but that performance boost is there for any of you who are looking to see performance numbers on beta 2. So guys, that's about it with iOS 12 Beta 2. If you want to hop onto the developer beta, there's a link down below. Or if you are already on the public beta, you should be getting an update pretty soon. If you guys like this video, make sure to hit that like button, get subscribed, and also stay tuned for some more upcoming content. You will not want to miss out. Anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and we hope to see you in our next video.